Senator Nigel Scullion says his new Indigenous housing plan will shake up the system.
Well, first of all, how we go about building houses is a matter that's a part. The government has in the past had what they call a national partnership agreement. In other words, all the states are treated the same. They get the money, the states go and build the houses. Now, some states have done quite well and others haven't. And in the territory context, it hasn't been particularly good. West Australia haven't been too bad. I think New South Wales bought their houses, didn't build any additional ones. So it's all been a bit here and there. So I'll send a signal that I'm inclined to look for a bilateral arrangement. What that means is that I'll be dealing directly with the West Australian government, dealing directly with the Northern Territory government, which gives me an opportunity to deal with a whole range of issues around a house.
However, the plan has come under fire, with the Northern Land Council and National Congress, amongst others, calling for greater consultation. An opposition Indigenous spokesperson, Shane Newman, publicly criticising the new policy.
If you go to the communities and you talk to the communities about these things, they're very supportive of this because it's their idea. And look, I'm sorry Shane's just sort of not on the program, and I don't expect him to be, but I would encourage him to go and talk to people about why it is that they don't have the same equity in life as he does. I recognise it, and it's sad that he doesn't.
While the new plan has strong links to the school attendance strategy, the minister says it will help pave the way for home ownership in Aboriginal communities.
Land ownership for Aboriginal people, they have little enough. In many places, that's all they have left. And I understand that these are really sensitive matters. And they need to be dealt with properly and sensibly, talking to the owners of country, talking to the elders of land, no matter where you are in Australia. But if we have the sort of things that's happening, the Tiwi Islands, Groote Island, Palm Island, where they're moving doggets to freehold, because they realise, if I want to be able to own my own house, it can't be part of a doggett anymore, because the underlying tenure isn't recognised by anyone, banks or anything. But if actually that changes, where I live today, nothing actually changes around me, except I can have some equity in my own life in exactly the same way as everybody else in Australia. So if I want a car, for example, and I've started paying off my house, I'll say, well, you've got some equity in your house, you can mortgage your house against buying a car, because that's what everybody else does. And you wonder why countrymen are always busted ass poor. Sorry, mate, but that's what it is.
It's the truth.
And it's because they don't have any equity in life in the same way as other people do. So this initiative is to allow Aboriginal people to have the same equity in their life as other Australians just take for granted.
Danny Tees Johnson in Darwin for NITV News.